Hello, once again, it's time for Come Share the Joy with your host, Deborah Schultz. So glad that you stopped by today and tuned in to WOTG Television. And we're glad to present this program in honor of our Lord and Savior. To Him be lifted up, to Him be all the glory through Christ Jesus. But today I want to introduce to you some of my friends, some of my old friends. When we were getting together to do the show, it's just a little segment talking about reminiscing about our children and how we raise our children together, and we've just had a lifetime together, 50 plus years. I knew them in school, and a couple are a little older than me and one's a little younger. But we raised our kids together, and our husbands were friends, and we just had a beautiful relationship. You know, if you go through life, this is a statistic. If you go through life and you have one true friend, you are blessed. A lot of people don't have that. I have been blessed with many. Now, I'm not going to name any names because you all know who you are. But I have some friends that I know that anytime that I call upon them, they're going to be there. They're going to be right there. But I want to sing to them right now this song, and it's titled, Old Friends. But first, I want you to meet my friends. And this song is to you guys, all my old friends. Old friends, after all of these years, my old friends, through the laughter and tears, old friends, what a priceless treasure. My old friends, like a rare piece of gold, old friends, make it great to grow old, old friends, with all I will hold to old. God must have known there'd be days on our own that we'd all lose the will to go on. And that's why He sent friends like you along. Like a rare piece of gold, my old friends, you make it great to grow old friends, with all I will hold to old friends. Nothing like those old friends. You know, when you're down and out and troubled, you just go and you just maybe pick up that phone and call that old friend. Somebody that you can just tell it all. Somebody that knows you almost as well as you know yourself. And they're there. Maybe just knock on their door and go in and have a cup of coffee and just cry together. Oh, my friends. But there's a friend. It's closer than a brother. His name is Jesus Christ. Today, if you don't know Him as your Savior, I pray that you find this friend sweet to your soul. Old friends, with all I will hold to old friends. The laughter and tears, old friends, we've had more than our share You've always been there, my old friend. We've had more than our share, old friend. We're all millionaires and old. Nothing like an old friend. You know, there's just people that you, there's people that you just come in contact with that, like, you know, you hear of soulmates. You know, you look at that person and you're like, and they look at you and you catch their eye, you know, immediately they're for you. You know, there are people like that. There's acquaintance that you just maybe just start talking to each other through a mutual friend or something, and it ends up, you just connect, you just got a bond, that, and you became old friends. The definition of a friend is a person who one knows and trusts and has a bond with. That's what a friend is. So if you go through life and you have one true friend, statistics say that you are blessed. My friend, I've got a lot of them. I've got some that's moved away. Sure, I miss them. But you know, we can pick up that telephone and we can talk and they're right there. And we just like, we never picked off, left off. Like Sharon and Brenda and Debbie, we met the other night. Brenda's having some health issues and she's going to have some more surgery. And we've went around that bad once and we're going again, but we're having faith to believe that God's going to move on her behalf. So keep her in your prayers. Her name is Brenda Lee. We're going to take off and go to the beach this week before Brenda has to go in for surgery again and have some testing. And so we're going to go have some girl time and just get away with old friends. But, you know, I like to get away with my friend. You know, all those friends, those fleshly friends, those earthly friends are wonderful. But I have a friend. The Word of God says in Proverbs 18 and 24, a man that has a friend must show himself friendly. And there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. And his name is Jesus Christ. John 15:13 says it like this. Greater love has no man than this, that he would lay down his life for his friend. I would hope to think that I could lay down my life for my friend. And we have soldiers out there right now protecting us that are willing to lay down their life for our safety. We need to be friends. That's what's wrong with this world. We have forgotten what a friend is. Other nations, we need to befriend people. Befriend each other. There's an old song that goes, what the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little love. And that's an old song from back in the 70s, I guess. And it was, I think Dionne Warwick sang it. She was one of my favorite pop singers, but that was a song. And she talks about, Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are hillsides enough to climb. We need love. A friend, that's what we need again today. Love, sweet love is what we need. But then we're going to go to Psalms 139. I'm just going to tell you how much this friend Jesus, when you ask him in, you heard us talking, us girls talking. Well, I did most of that talking, but I do that quite often. But I sat there and I thought about when we were all converted and how that it was like a little fire. You know, one was converted, one asked Jesus into their life, and then we saw something in them. I saw something in Debbie that I wanted. I saw some peace. And then it was contagious. Then it went to Sharon. Then it went to Brenda. And then my Bob got saved. And then I think then Bill got, James got saved, then Bobby got saved, then Bill got saved, and it's a wonderful thing. You can help lead others to Jesus. But here is the friend that he is, and I love this. Psalms 139, 1 through 4 says, "You have searched me, Lord, and you know me." You know, our friends know us. They know some things that nobody else knows, and they keep them hidden in their hearts. But God knows you before you open your mouth. It says here, number 2, "You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar." He knows exactly what you're thinking. He knows what you're thinking right now. Some people have some things going through their mind. What is the thought? Said you can't keep a bird from nesting, flying, but you can't keep him from nesting. Get it out of there. Call on your friend. Jesus is your friend. He knows your thoughts. But don't give in to them. Don't give in to that sin pleasure. Don't give in to the flesh. Verse 3. "You discern my going out and my lying down. You are familiar with all of my ways." He knows everything about you. He knows what you like to eat. I know that Debbie, my friend Debbie that we had dinner with the other night, loves pasta. She loves spaghetti. Sharon loves strawberry pie. Brenda loves oysters. I know these things. Because they're my friends. You see, I know that my friend Susan, who has moved to Wisconsin, she doesn't like dumplings. Can't stand dumplings. My friend Pat Hookie that I met many years ago down in Nashville, Tennessee, it was like that. There's something drew us to each other. And she lives in Tennessee and I live here in West Virginia. But we've been friends, old friends, for many years. There's just a bond. My friend Pam, my Lord, she'd be right there. She cries with me. She starts crying before I start crying. She knows me so well. And there's so many more of you. Number 4, verse 4 says, "Before a word is out of my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely." Before I speak a word, he knows already. He knows my thoughts. He knows what I'm going to do tomorrow. God help me to listen to you, friend. He is your friend. He is your father. I am a friend of God. There's a song. I am a friend of God. Oh, and he is our friend. But then I've got another old song here. And this is really, really an old one. My friend Nora. She's in Virginia, and when we talk every night, it's that widow bond that bonded us. We've known each other for many years, 30-some years, but when she became a widow, and I'm a widow, we just got a special bond. God knows what he's doing. He knows the people to put in our lives. But this song goes, "I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. The lily of the valley, the bright morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul." Oh, he is. That's who he is. I have found a friend in Jesus. Now, I love all you friends I've been talking about. But Jesus is my friend. Nothing can separate me from his love. Those miles when your friend moves away, that distance that you have when you're raising your kids and they're raising their kids, and we don't see each other that often, but when we do, we pick right back up where we were. But Jesus never leaves you. He's right there, and if you are not having in a good relationship with him, pick up where you left off. Let him become Lord of your life. But tonight, today, tomorrow, forever, let him be Lord of your life. Because without him, we are nothing, my friend. He is who we call on. Now, you can call on me. You can call our prayer line at 304-687-3579. I have a prayer team that's willing to pray at any hour. You can contact me with my website, DeborahSchultzMinistries.com. Or you can contact me at my email address is DeborahDD@Suddenlink.net. All those go together on me when I'm trying to tell you those. But I thank God. He's just a whisper away. He's a friend at all times, night, day, where if you're lonely, he is there. And I just want to thank him. And I pray right now, Father, that if the listener out there doesn't know you as their Savior, I pray that you just call upon the name of Jesus. He'll come in and he'll take abode in you and he'll never leave you. And I thank you, God, for the ones that may have grown cold. Maybe they don't have a friend here on this earth, God. Help us to show ourselves friendly. Bible says, if you want a friend, be a friend. You got to be a friend, and you'll get a friend. But I know right now that God can answer prayer. And right now, Brenda, I'm going to sing this for you. It's called Be Still. When we don't know what to say, when we don't know what to pray. I wrote this back several months ago. In the stillness of my heart, I hear you whisper. And I know you are with me all the way. Though sometimes my life is so lost and out of rhyme, Lord, I listen and I hear you softly say, be still and know that I am with you. I'll be with you through the storms of today, and tomorrow take no thought with you, for I'll be with you every step of the way. When my heart was broken and all I felt but sadness, you were there, Lord, to pick me up. And then I heard your gentle whisper, I'm right here with you every step of your. Be still and know that I am with you. I'll be with you from the storms of today, and tomorrow take no thought with you, for I'll be every step of your way. And know that I am with you. I'll be with you through the storms of today, and tomorrow take no thought for I'll be with you every step of your way. And I'll be with you every step of your way. your way. Friend, he'll be there. Trust him. Love him. And let him be your best friend. God bless you. And again, I thank you. I thank God for my sponsors. I thank him for WOTG Television for allowing me to have this program on their air. And I thank God for my sponsors, Old Hilliard Plumbing, Hilliard, Ohio, near Columbus, Ohio. That phone number is 614-777-9320. Give Old Hilliard Plumbing a call and tell them you heard it on Come Share the Joy. So with that being said, God bless you. Thank you for tuning in, and we'll see you next week.